Anyway, we're just a few minutes from showtime, but it wouldn't be a Ubisoft E3 without a hype reel. So everyone at home here, turn the volume up all the way to 11 and let's go.
Yeah, I'll turn it up, man.
Here we go, guys. They're starting. Let's do it. Is this it? Almost. We got 5 minutes left. 5 minutes. Rayman, please. I don't think they're gonna do a new Rayman, man. Well, they might, since they're not announcing Assassin's Creed this year. They could have been spending some more time on other stuff. When are you gonna play Overwatch? Soon. Very, very soon. Jetpack says, whoa, this is Rayman Origins 2. I think you're a little off, maybe. Could you imagine Rayman in a war zone? He's Shadow the Hedgehog, dude. Oh, Raven Rabbits, please, no more Raven Rabbits. Oh, God. Please, no more of that. When will you play Fire Emblem? When I get a new capture method that actually is reliable. That doesn't require me to spend thousands.
That was our year in review. Everyone make some more noise.
All right,
Justin, what's up?
So just a quick reminder, if you want to join the conversation, please use the hashtag UBE3.
I know the fucking,
coming to you live from
the ARM9 loader hacks, 3DS hack, it stopped working for me as well, so it's not smooth anymore. I don't know why I did that.
We've got interviews, we've got a
but
tour,
the game doesn't run anymore like they did.
All the games that you're going to see here at the conference.
Silver Absol YT says, anything you're expecting and hoping for Ubisoft? More Watch Dogs 2, and that's all I really have in mind. And Aisha Tyler, that's it.
In a few minutes. All right, now that about does it for a pre-show. Yes, I know it's a sad moment.
Jens Graham says, "You need money for a capture card, real quick." No, no, I do not. I'm not gonna fucking buy another capture card from Katsuki. I mean, okay, like on a real note, like I guess eventually I will buy a new capture card, but I gotta like figure it out because. I don't want to buy another one if she's making them the way she currently is.
Crew out there, thank you very much.
Navi, hey, yes, listen, join in the spawns crew.
Hey!
Listen! Yo, throwback. All
right.
What's going on? Thank you.
Chad, are you having fun?
Oh my god,
thank you.
The most amazing thing ever!
Chad, what's going on, bro? Yo, let's give a clap for Chad, man. Let's give a clap for Chad.
Very important, very important. Please, no smoking inside. I know. That's going to be difficult for the French teams. No smoking, please. See, 1 o'clock. Thank you.
Oh, yes, I do have one more thing. We have a 360 camera up there. So if you guys want to wave to the 360 camera, we're going
to
be putting that on.
Hey, guys, wave to the camera.
Yeah, 360.
Wave to the camera.
It's the future.
All right. Now, that does it for Justin and myself.
Does that do it?
I don't know. Are you guys ready? Are you guys hyped? No.
Actually,
type the 360 cameras a stupid nigger in the chat.
Yeah, I think a better
one. No, I'm gonna get my stream shut down.
You recognize Avery from our favorite fan video.
I'm gonna get my stream shut down, bro.
Without an awkward fan interaction.
I deny everything.
And an awkward ass laugh. Did you see that?
That was a good one. Tyler.
That was a good one.
Let's
oh,
do
man.
That shit!
Oh my god. Ubisoft, I love these guys for their fan interaction. But sometimes the cringe is too real. The cringe is too real sometimes. And we have Aisha Tyler, the queen of cringe when it comes to E3. But hey, but I still love her. I still deal with you, Aisha. 30 years old, though. I wonder how she's going to come on stage this time. Is this the Metaton? Oh, you will die. That Metaton singing? Oh, Just Dance. What's the difference between all these games, man? Christine, have you ever been interested in Just Dance? Yeah, me. We're not 12. Who's playing this game, man? Are you playing Just Dance? Is it you? I know it's gotta be you. You look like one of the motherfuckers that be playing Just Dance. This is one of those famous songs, alright? Isn't this by Queen? How dare you disgrace Queen's name? How dare you? A legend, and you're disgraced? I'm playing around, I'm sorry. I am such an asshole. Yeah, this is Queen. Silver, what's going on? Did you just say I look like I play Just Dance? Also, who the fuck is Miss Tyler? Is she cute? I mean, she's somewhat attractive. She's usually the host of the E3 Ubisoft press conferences. You know her. You've seen her before. Aisha Tyler, you've seen her. That's her right there with the red shoes on. We love her and we hate her at the same time. It's a love-hate relationship. Let's do that shit.
You guys are awesome. You guys were confusing and awesome. And my mom has those boots, by the way. She wants them back. Ladies and gentlemen, you know when you see a dancing crab and a baby bird with a paper collar that you could only be at the Ubisoft E3 press conference. Welcome.
Yeah.
Welcome. True. Dancers, can you guys bring it in behind me for a second? Just gather around.
True that.
Get behind me here. It's a special year. And I want to take a moment to do something that's going to feel a little...
Is that pyrocynical over there on the left?
Even uncomfortable for some of you. There's no smooth or easy way to do this, but...
I heard he's a furry that goes to furry conventions.
That we needed to say this. So before we start, everyone here at Ubisoft want to offer our deepest sympathies to the people affected by this weekend's tragedy in Orlando. Our hearts, the hearts of everyone in Paris, in France, in the United States, and around the world are with you. And now...
This is such a serious message, I know. But I just can't take it seriously when you have a fucking giraffe right next to you. You get the fucking giraffe talking about... It's such a sad event. I know.
A human giraffe on my right and a candy cane on my left. I'm going to make a very hard right turn.
Shuji.
And get into the fun stuff. Thanks for coming on, guys. Dance away.
Shuji, atatacha. What's
Dance
going on?
Away.
You keep unsponsoring and responding. What's going on, Shuji?
The madness
Thank
that
you for
just
back.
Saw was courtesy of the Movement Wizards at Just
Or is
Dance
this your first time sponsoring? You donate a lot.
Just
I don't know if you sponsored
yet.
Just Dance
has always been at the forefront of innovation, bringing its experience to new devices and also introducing the world to the first dance-on-demand streaming service with Just Dance Unlimited. And today, Ubisoft is pleased to announce that Just Dance 2017 will be coming to all video game platforms and PC in October and to the Nintendo NX next year.
She said NX? Whoa, Nintendo's gonna fucking kill these guys.
Complete.
Wait a minute, guys, hold on, wait. Okay, Nintendo specifically don't want anybody mentioning anything about the NX. When it comes to developers or any kind of games upcoming, they don't want them to say for the NX. And they even went as far as to censor sometimes companies that mention the NX in their advertisements as a platform that they're going to be supporting in the future. So, I don't know. Nintendo's about to hit her with the Genji stars real quick.
Downtown Los Angeles. It's true, right? It's underneath everything.
She said NX.
The badges are on everyone's necks and the smiles on everyone's faces can
unless
only mean
they
one
got
thing.
Clearance from Nintendo. Did Nintendo say,
and
yeah, you can tell them it's going to be an NX? And okay.
Year for everyone here at Ubisoft. It's my fifth time hosting this conference. Yes.
We love you, Aisha.
And you all know what the traditional gift is for a fifth anniversary, yeah? That's right, my friends. Wood. Or girl wood, if
damn,
you choose. Son, let it wash over you.
Oh,
people,
God.
They always ask me, like, why do I continue to do this conference in the face of the overwhelming internet love that I receive?
Suji, we're going to re-smash. We're going to be smashing soon.
And it's not the
we're
going to
be smashing soon,
Suji.
Trust me.
Ubisoft is French.
Wow. She really took a hit at that.
They're painting me in red wine and sarcasm, you guys.
Bear Brawler, what's going on, man? Thank you for joining
the
sponsor,
Bear. No, I
come back
every year because I love games.
Thank you.
I play these games, I adore them, and I love being a part of the excitement that comes with revealing new games to the world. Every day, every year when I do this, I'm like a kid in a candy store. A really large, slightly masculine kid in a candy store. And speaking of excitement, it's Ubisoft's 30th birthday. Yeah, give it up for Ubi. Or Ubi. Ubi may be 30,
damn,
but
son,
like everyone else here in Hollywood,
this?
It hasn't aged a bit. Gets drunk on weekdays and dresses inappropriately, but whatever makes it feel young. Now, over these three decades, Ubisoft has been flexing its creative muscles.
Silver!
And teams the freedom to push back.
Silver, you can't say stuff
that
like that. That's fucked
fun,
up.
And sometimes a little crazy. So,
Silver!
Talk. We're going to hit
how
fast
rude.
Right now and get straight to the games. All right? Now,
Silver.
You may remember our next title from the end of last year's show. When it blew your fucking mind. And if you're at home playing a drinking game, yes,
how
it's a bomb in the first 5 minutes of this show.
Oh,
ladies and gentlemen,
drink.
Welcome
we
back to Ghost Recon Wildlands.
Hey, you know what, Aisha, if you want me to drink, I'm gonna drink, baby girl, fuck it, we got this Pinot Grigio.
I offer the people a choice.
To Genji?
Me or oppose me.
Look, we're opening it right now.
If you follow me, I feed your families.
Aisha Taylor,
shelter,
Tyler, medicine, bottoms up, my girl.
Job. Shield you from the tyrants. Allow La Santa Muerte to protect you from death. I give you power. I make you rich. But most of all, I let you rule like kings. But for those that oppose me, I have only one thing to offer. A promise. To take everything you
what
love.
What the hell is this? Far Cry?
And destroy it.
It looks like Far Cry. Where am I wrong? Strawberry West Cream says, fuck that shit. Go get my strawberry alcohol. West Cream?
It's all yours.
Is that an alcohol strawberry?
Go.
Fuck it, I guess we will. Oh no, this ain't. Yeah, this is not Far Cry. What are your guesses, guys? Grim Fandango? You have a priest. That's Manny Foso? Tom Clancy shit? Oh, okay, Ghost Recon. Okay, Tom Clancy.
In Bolivia, the coca leaf is core to the culture. It's found in every gas station, every hospital, and every town.
I really wish Nintendo... Oh no, they're buffering. Oh no.
And they use it for a variety of things, like treating nausea and altitude sickness.
I would love if Nintendo did something like this, man. It's been so long since we've seen a live presentation from Nintendo.
To make cocaine. So we asked, what if? What if a Mexican drug cartel moved in, took over the entire country, seized all of those coca resources to become the number one producer of cocaine on the planet, effectively turning Bolivia into a narco state? This is the world of Ghost Recon Wildlands. And you? Well, you're the ghosts. The elite spec ops drop deep behind enemy lines to create chaos and disrupt the alliance between a corrupt local government and the Santa Blanca cartel, ultimately going after their leader, the vicious El Sueño.
El Sueño?
Hi, everybody. My name is Dominic Butler. Aye, aye, aye. I'm the lead game designer for Ghost Recon Wildlands.
I'm in love with the cocoa. I got it for you. Are you
Ghost
in love
Recon
with
Wildlands
the cocoa?
Is the very first military shooter set in a massive, dangerous open world that you can play entirely in solo or in up to four player co-op.
El Chapo game?
With beautiful environments set across a variety of different ecosystems that will challenge and influence your gameplay at every step of the way. All of this takes place in the largest action-adventure open world Ubisoft has ever done. Now, in the gameplay we're about to show you...
It's not my mic, it's their mic.
Ghosts already have a target. His name is El Pozolero. He's known as the Stew Maker because he makes the bodies disappear. Now, the ghosts know that their target is in a large Santa Blanca camp somewhere in the San Mateo province, but they don't know where yet exactly. And because Ghost Recon Wildlands gives you the total freedom of choice to do what you want, when you want, we put the power back in the player's hands to achieve their objectives their way. In this case, the ghosts know...
Niggas are saying in the chat, free El Chapo.
Vital
what the
intel.
Fuck?
They want to take him alive, so they've opted for a tactical extraction. Let's go get that intel.
Tom Clancy's a fucking
house. Looks like it's upstairs.
Copy that.
Need any help?
Nah,
that's not funny.
This. Okay, I'll take a look around.
Tom Clancy's a fucking...
Right, let's try to keep it stealthy. There's one right there. Oh, gotcha.
El Pozolero. El Pozolero.
I'm in.
Rest in peace, Tom Clancy.
Oh shit, I've been spotted.
You good?
Sleep well.
Yep, got it. Just move upstairs. Alright, let's see what we got.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Timmer is bad saying there's a petition to put Christina Grimmie into Zelda
okay,
Wii U
I got the intel
and
on
NX as a tribute to her because she was
San
a huge
Mateo.
Fan of it.
Cool, how far is it?
We
that's touching us up.
You got a car out there?
No. Something better.
I'm gonna check that out after this, man. Thank you, Timorous.
You ready to fly?
Let's go.
You got it.
According to the intel, the camp should be near this cliff.
El Pozolero is a high-value target, and he's gonna be well protected.
There's a camp. Oh, damn, this one's gonna be tough.
Yeah, we could definitely use some backup on this one.
Hey, you guys need a hand?
Right on time. We're going after El Pozolero. We're at the east of the San Mateo base.
Got it. We are on our way.
We're approaching the camp from the west. We'll meet you there.
Copy that. I hear this El Pozolero guy is supposed to be a hard target.
How bad does it look?
See for yourself.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Clyde saying hello from France, Etika. Saw your Undertale stream where you got drunk. Don't drink soap this time. Won't be drinking no soap. Don't worry.
Roger that. One less to worry about.
That stream is crazy.
Can you get to a good sniper position on the south side of the camp?
I still gotta make highlights of it.
Alrighty, I'm moving in from the other side.
Copy that. We're moving in from the train station at the east end of camp.
I'll be right back.
Heads up, enemy spotted. I got eyes on a sniper.
Wait for my signal.
Got it. Now, tango down. Let's move. Okay, wait a minute.
I hear something inside. Two guys. I got the one on the right. You ready?
Ready.
Go.
Good job.
Okay, I'm gonna deploy the drone and see what's up ahead.
Let me try to get immersed into this, man. I don't want to seem like a total douchebag by not, like, focusing on it. But, you know, with there's a lot of shooters that we've seen. After a little while, sometimes they all kind of blend together. But this one looks interesting with this feature.
Oh, man, there are guards all over.
Tom Clancy is different from standard, you know? It is.
Yep, be careful.
Because games always have, you know, something else to them.
Found my way in, guys. Let's see what's in this big building.
Like some kind of unified effort?
Okay, I got him. Red gloves, gas mask. He's got guards with him.
Got it.
You see the way he's got the bodies just fucking in the drums?
Moving through. Gotcha. Okay, I'm close to the building.
This is definitely a game to play with friends. Definitely.
He was dissolving somebody.
Like in a can of acid or something.
Yeah, looked pretty nasty.
Come on, guys, let's move.
All right. I think I found my spot. Nearly there.
Daft is good saying, I'm still salty. I never got my shout out. Also, this isn't holding my attention. Daft, sorry about not shouting you out, man. I'm getting it now, man. Thank you big time for the sponsor, man.
Okay, I'm in position.
I have three tangles.
Yeah, I hear you.
You can help.
Maybe I'm not too hot on this. But hey, it could change. I like the multiplayer part. I'll be right back. Silver.
Going in.
Don't let this guy get away.
See him. We'll talk about nightmare fuel.
Call us if you need us.
Don't worry, man. I got this. Shit! He spotted me. Guys, I'm spotted. El Pozolero's running. I'm going after him. Where is he? Get out of the way, man. Okay, he's in a white SUV heading for the east
end of the camp, following on a bike.
Got it. I'm moving intercept.
This camp's on full alert, guys. We need to get out of here fast.
Shit, Hulk, get in the car.
Where is he? Shit, no, he's moving too fast. He went the other way.
Come on, man. Let's go.
Hurry up. The gate's closing.
I am right behind you. Weaver, are you okay?
I'm good.
Frag out.
I'm pulling out. Found a bike, guys. I'm on my way.
Hey, watch your fire. We need him alive.
I can't get a good shot.
This guy's all over the place.
Stop moving.
God, I'm missing like half the fucking
guys,
conference.
I'm clear. Out of the camp, on the road.
My bad.
You guys, let me know you're... Damn, the whole place is going up. Alright, I'm heading for the chopper now.
Silver Absol says, Tom Clancy might be different than standard, but not as different as something like Team Fortress 2 or Splatoon. That's why you're not really excited about it. I guess, maybe.
Help is on the way, guys. I'll run this train.
Wait, Soul Scientist said, aren't you an entertainer, Etika? You need to drink soap for the sake of our enjoyment. No!
Okay, RDJ,
is this not enough for you? And then Joryukin saying, this is for you, my man. I hope you like it. Also, when we battle in Overwatch, Joryukin?
Oh, no, he's not stopping.
Thank you, Joryukin.
Come on, I'm
means a lot that you go out of your way to do something like that just to fucking put a smile on my face. I appreciate it. And when it comes to Overwatch, my list is crazy, but I'm going to try to straighten it out, man, and we'll get a game in soon, trust me. But Jory, thanks. Man, and the fucking thing is lagging. Commander Strider saying, fuck the soap, my boy. Drink the bleach instead. I got it here for a reason. With enough cringe? Yeah, who knows? Maybe I will. Right now, YouTube is buffering this shit, man. What the fuck?
Be careful.
Ride's here.
How'd you get, buddy?
Nintendo at 4:30?
Damn, son. Hurry up, we got cartel reinforcements incoming.
Coghog? Coghog, you're in here? First time donating. Really hope I get surprised at Nintendo's little thing tomorrow. You and I both, man. You and I both.
And we are clear, gentlemen.
Nice work.
That was a tough mission.
Oh, man, that was close.
Nintendo is going to be on YouTube Gaming's E3 stream. Really? Alright, I'm gonna open my thing for that. Let me see.
Head over to ghostrecon.com right now for all the latest news and gameplay videos. For those of you here at E3, please come by the booth. We've got 4-player co-op demos and we would love for you to try it. We want to get your feedback.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Ghost Recon Wildlands will be released.
Not so more wine, damn it. Oh god, Jen. Oh god, leave me.
Thank you.
Oh god, Jen. Is this what you want? Oh god. Jen, please, no more. No more. Oh.
Crime in the United States is escalating.
Oh god.
The statistics
are
urban centers are oversaturated with violence.
I don't have Overwatch on PS4, but I have it on PC only. Sorry.
The wave of criminal activity has overrun.
Sorry about that, Shuji. I might get it on PS4 eventually.
Dissolution of moral structure, international conspiracies, a multi-billion-dollar drug trade. No one knows the source, and authorities are helpless in stopping this epidemic of crime. Civilization is being pushed to the brink. To stem the rising tide of violence and re-establish order, extreme steps must be taken. The question becomes, who will take them?
Is this Sonic? Woo! Oh, it's fucking South Park.
Oh, wow. Schroeder from Ubisoft San Francisco. I had the team put together a trailer. We just took some stuff from Snowdrop and said, make cool trailer, and that's what it puts out. So that's kind of the way that goes. But all that chaos, all that scary stuff is totally true. Thankfully, the coon is up to the occasion. And
damn,
who better
son,
to defend the town of South
this?
Park and really Colorado and really the world than superheroes or kids
Elite
in
two.
Costumes?
So, where's Rayman?
Like
we don't know.
Friends,
that's the only one you care about?
Please welcome Trey Parker.
Planet Robobot? I'm not sure when I'll be playing that, man, but... You know, I mean, because right now playing 3DS games on stream is a little tough, but I might play it on my own time. 3DS is very annoying to play right now on camera.
Comfy couch. This
yeah.
is sweet.
All right, guys, we're going to close donations now. I think we're going to close them.
I know, it's an exhausting because
it's starting to get... You know, I kind of want to pay attention. I'm curious.
So let's talk about the story. Everybody wants to know what's going on in the fractured butthole.
Don't know yet.
Yeah.
Pretty soon. Well, it really...
I don't know. I mean, I'm interested.
It just picks up where the Stick of Truth kind of left off. You're the new kid. If you play Stick of Truth, you would know that... And you're the new kid who moved.
These niggas are the big boys. Yeah, oh, shit.
So the game's really about who you are, and you kind of define who you are in South Park. But
Stick of Truth, I heard, was a great
game. It's
like
a fantasy send up, and you end up being the king in the end. And it's like the next day in South Park, and the kids have sort of switched up, and now they're playing superheroes.
Right.
Right?
Yeah, and so we actually have a backstory that the kids have been playing superhero, but they got into a big fight about something, so they're in the Civil War. Yep. Part of their
kind of civil war.
And in fact, Marvel wanted to call their movie Captain America the Fractured Butthole, but we had already taken that name. So they had to,
yeah, all right,
to call
bullshit.
Their Civil War.
Uh-huh.
True.
It's a true story. That's true. Extremely true.
But also, you know, we want to get into who you are as this new kid. And the fact that, you know, in Stick of Truth, you really...
Jetpack X says, what happened to that dude's hairline?
But in this game, they've kind of switched games, and so you're...
Can we get RIP for his hairline, please?
Right, so let's see how that douchebag was able to make it into Kunin Fan.
Stop. No more.
Dude, what the fuck? Who let this ordinary citizen into the Kunin lair? Listen, bro, we are all superheroes, and you aren't, so you can't hang out with us. Please do us all a solid and...
This nigga Cartman. Wow.
Hey! Do not touch that! That device can blow up the entire Milky Way galaxy! Jesus, fuck! Mom! The new kid is trying to play with the cube of ultimate destruction!
You be nice to all your friends, Eric. Be a good sharer.
Good sharer? It'll blow up the fucking galaxy! Stupid bitch!
Wow.
I told you, you can't play. You aren't a superhero. You don't have a costume. You don't have any superpowers. Freedom Pals are adding people to their franchise. We should be adding people to ours. This dork? Like, wearing a little crown? Does this look like a superhero to you? All right. Have a seat, douchebag.
This nigga Cartman is a savage, man.
Not there. That's Mysterion's seat. Not there either, stupid. All right, in order to play superheroes, you have to have a superhero persona. Then you can fill out your character sheet on Kunstagram. Do you have a Kunstagram page?
Kunstagram.
Oh boy, you're not even on Kunstagram, huh? Well, I guess I can create one for you. So the first thing we need to fill out on your character sheet is your class. You know, what kind of superhero are you?
This is the creation process?
Feaster, yes, like the Flash or Quicksilver. I like it.
Yes, wow.
Woo!
That's what I'm thinking.
Sure.
Wow.
It was really important to us to be able to, and you guys, to be able to really create your own superhero. So that you saw on that UI that there are a dozen different superhero classes you can choose from. You mix and match powers from those classes and really make a superhero all your own. But what else is new in the Fractured But Whole?
Well, I mean, that's obviously...
Instagram is Coonstagram anyways. I mean, that's racist as fuck.
I mean, it's definitely more of a... There's definitely more of defining your character and kind of... In superhero movies, there's always, like, the intense emotional center that, like, motivates why you have to go out and fight crime. So it's a much... As you can already tell, it's a much...
No, South Park's Stick of Truth was really good.
It's more spiritual game. It's right. Much more about...
It's like, there's... there's actually a part of it that I'm really proud of where there's a gay fish in South Park and... He loves fish sticks, and the gay fish actually wants you to help him get his mother into heaven. And so you get to journey up and try to help this little gay fish get his mom into heaven, and you're all acting like this shit's regular.
Shit is hard.
The shit is hard.
It was hard.
These niggas are fucking clowns, bro.
If you didn't see the Kanye thing, that won't make it.
But
he doesn't know.
Cartman, how do you not know the joke? In charge of telling each superhero what their tragic backstory was that made them a superhero, and so this is what he comes up with.
Who let this guy join us anyway?
Go easy on him, you guys. He's had a tough life. It's time they learned your tragic backstory. You lay awake that night, like so many other nights. You couldn't sleep because you knew you weren't like the other kids. You walked to the mirror. You looked in the mirror and you felt alone. And that's when it happened. A loud noise. You swore you could hear your mother calling for help.
Oh my god.
You left your room.
Yo.
Seriously, dude, just walk through the door already? But then you finally reached your parents' door. What you saw when you opened that door changed your life forever and led you to fighting crime. You were too late, because when you opened that door, you saw your dad fuck your mom.
Oh.
What? Butthole doesn't trust anyone because his dad fucked his mom. Couldn't do anything to stop him. That doesn't make any sense.
I know. How could the person you trust do that to the only other person you love?
Cartman, everyone's dad fucked everyone's mom.
Huh?
That's how it works, stupid. Our dads fuck our moms.
Shit.
Does that mean your dad fucked your mom, Cal? Huh?
Yes! My dad fucked my mom! That's why I'm here! Don't steal his backstory, dude. That's not cool.
Wow! Carmen is a fucking fool, bro.
I can see there's a lot of people that relate to that story.
Yeah, it's very personal for us, and apparently that does touch a lot of people.
Yeah,
there's
it does.
There's very few people that can at least relate to it at some level, except for Jesus. So, forgot that one out. So obviously that's pretty brutal.
These niggas are fucking fools, man.
Brutal, our combat, and we worked on that a lot together.
Yeah, the combat system is much improved from Stick of Truth, and it's a superhero game, so it has the combat is definitely the center.
Yeah, it was actually pretty cool because we, us and the guys from Ubisoft, we'd come down and talk about what this game would be, and we'd go back to my house afterwards and play board games because I'm a big board gamer. So we'd play all like my favorite board games and tabletop miniature of games and figure out how to, you know, we still wanted to keep some of the turn-based stuff because it.
The loops.
Really
I've been all right, man.
To do
things have been good.
So,
I just haven't.
So we just tried to do a
done much after all the crazy shit. But I've been good, dude. Trying to get excited for this E3 shit, dude. Microsoft was crazy.
What we ended up putting in is belt combat space and time. So let's talk about it. First, let's talk about space. You're not restricted to a location anymore. Now you can move to get into tactical positions on your enemies. Ooh.
Wow.
You can also move to get behind cover. You can push and pull enemies. But they can also do it to you. Ugh. You can knock them into props and get a little extra damage.
What the hell?
You can knock them into other characters and get an extra attack. You can use some of your powers like Tweak here to get over obstacles. So obviously using space makes a big difference.
Are they fighting prostitutes? What in the hell? That okay.
In the first game, your farts were legendary. Now your farts are so powerful that you can use them to rip the fabric of time itself.
Like Ghost Recon.
Yeah. So you can use that to rearrange the turn order. Mastering space and time makes a huge difference. I can't wait for you guys to get your hands on it. Let's bring it out with big volume.
What in the hell is happening? This game looks fucking ridiculous, yo. You can tell they had a lot of fun making this game. You can see they had a damn good time making this.
That was pretty cool. Yeah. So then we did all that, and now we do the business part.
Business part? Oh, awesome. What's that part?
There's actual business that happens with it?
To work on, and I think both of our teams have been having a ton of fun, and we're almost done, and now we have some exciting news for our South Park fans before we go. Anyone who buys the Fractured But Whole will get the Stick of Truth for PS4, Xbox One, and Steam for free. If you pre-purchase the game today...
Very nice. Very nice.
The game today, Fractured But Whole, that is, and you can start playing Stick of Truth right away. So check out our website and for information and about our participating retailers. Right?
Yeah.
Cool.
Sounds great.
You don't want to.
So, we made a trailer if you want to see it.
Yeah.
Sort of shows what the boys are fighting about that was the Civil War Fractured Butthole part of
people
it.
People want to know the release date, probably, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
what
do you think
it is? What do you think it is?
I'm putting my money on December 6th.
Holiday? Sounds right.
Fractured Butthole will be released on December 6th.
Diamond Gamer says, I want a Fractured Butthole.
There it is. Thank you.
I'm sure you do.
Everybody.
Thanks.
Enjoy the trailer.
Why did we choose this life? Why did we become superheroes? We dedicate our lives to fighting crime for one reason. To make $1 billion on a superhero franchise. Now let's
really?
Go through the plan one more time. First, we start with the Coon movie. Then we do the Super Craig movie. Then Super Craig and Coon will join forces in the Human Kite movie just as we start ramping up Kitty's Netflix series. How come I have to have the Netflix series? I want a movie too. You have a movie, Mysterion. You're in the third Coon and Friends United movie after your Netflix series.
Yeah, but he's saying he doesn't ever get his own movie. Do I get my
own
movie?
You know damn
not
well what the
pattern. Not everyone gets their own movie. franchise plan sucks. If we want to make billions of dollars, then I think we should start with the Tupperware movie.
Right, start with a black superhero.
Marvel is making a black superhero movie.
Yeah, now! They waited years to get to that. We follow their plan. We do all the real people first, and we sneak the black guy in phase three.
How about we starring all of us, like all the time? But then we're just rehashing the same old material.
There's nothing wrong with doing the exact same movie to start a franchise.
Okay, J.J. Abrams.
Okay, oh, okay, so you're on Cartman's side?
He just likes this plan because he gets two movies in phase one.
God! We have to just go with this plan. We don't even have one movie yet.
What the fuck?
How did it get to this? How did we grow so far apart?
You go with the plan. Maybe we'll just go and do our own franchise.
Yeah.
Yeah!
Oh, you want Civil War? Is that what you want? Yeah, dude, Civil War. Fuck you. Oh, fuck you. Get out of my house.
Yo.
We'll make way more money on our franchise.
Go ahead. I bet you don't even get halfway through phase one on your franchise, DC Comics.
I thought Civil War wasn't supposed to happen until phase three.
Shut up, Super Craig.
Wow. I'm feeling the drink get to me. God damn it. God damn it. I'm about to get real ignorant in this motherfucker.
But you leave me no choice.
Did I just hear someone use a macroaggression?
Oh, God. Yo, this game looks fucking crazy.
If you have been playing that drinking game at home, you probably fell asleep on your computer.
Dude, I'm ready to fucking...
And now we move from the flatulent, prepubescent superheroes of South Park to the snowy, post-pandemic streets of New York in Tom Clancy's
The Division.
Thanks to all of you out there, The Division broke records when it launched earlier this year, and today more than 10 million of you have spent up to 3 hours a day hitting a steady supply of high-value targets and trying to get your hands on the best loot in the Dark Zone. Well, here to tell us more about what's new in The Division, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Julian Garrity, creative director from Massive Entertainment.
She's almost as nice as mine.
Hey, how's it going, Julian? Welcome. All right.
Thank you. And thank you for wearing those shoes.
I like to make everybody feel...
I'm not actually that short.
No, no. You're actually taller than me without these shoes on. I'm sorry.
I'll go with it. And thanks to all the Division players out there who are so passionate about our game.
Yeah. It's a cool, cool-ass game. And you guys have been adding all kinds of new stuff to the game since it debuted. We heard just a little while ago about the Underground, so do you want to tell us more about what's going on with
Absolutely.
That?
Absolutely. So, in Underground, you and your team will be fighting against a dangerous threat hidden beneath the streets of New York City. And every time you play, the challenge is unique. That means endless replayability and even better rewards the further you go.
Okay, so, I mean, one of the coolest things about this game is it is open world, it is so robust, and you're making it more robust all the time. So are you going to tell us when we're going to get this new content, or do I just have to start taking bets? I know, okay. I'm big and I'm also pushy.
Yes.
I agree.
Underground will be out June 28th on Xbox One and PC and August 2nd on PS4. And this is just one of the updates we'll be releasing this year. Because for the Division team, this is a long-term commitment. We love this world. You love this world. We're going to keep on making it better for you.
It's awesome. I mean, you know, I've been in love with this game since you guys first debuted it. And I'm one of the shows that I have said.
Oh, man. All right. I'm getting a little turned off this shit.
That's not
I'm getting a little turned. I'm sorry. Today. We've got oh, man. I shouldn't have drank.
To celebrate Ubisoft's 30th birthday, we're giving our fans three exclusive outfits to use in-game. Ghost Recon, Rainbow Six, and Splint 7.
You get an outfit. You get an outfit.
The Division is... Oh, come on, guys.
You get the three outfits. Good for you, Chaz.
So, if you're a member of Ubisoft Club...
Jory Ken, once again. This is all the moolah I got. I've been saving it to get... Thank you. Ah, thank Jory. Come on.
Or three or four games together that you love.
Don't tell the other two.
I don't know. I have a lot of feelings. I love it. Well, I'm super stoked about running around Manhattan in trifocal goggles without getting arrested.
Thank you, Jory. You want some Cinnamon Toast Crunch?
So, we've got Underground. We've got dope new outfits.
More. Dope.
We've got one more expansion to talk to you about today. In it, you'll struggle to find meager supplies in New York and fight to survive in some of the most brutal weather conditions imaginable. It's a completely new way of playing the game, and you'll be able to play it very soon. even sooner if you're on Xbox One or PC. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Survival.
I never really played The Division, so I guess I'm not too interested in myself, but...
But we had to investigate the rumors of a cure.
The concept is always crazy to me. How the virus... No, in this world, it's kill or be killed.
Go, go, go.
Sally, what's going on, Sally? Sally, what's going on? How you doing, girl? Glad to see you in there. Is Etika know why cinnamon toast crunch tastes so great? Because I'm eating it out of a cup? Order delivery? What should I eat?
Evacuation area compromised.
But some of us will survive.
Fucking Jason Voorhees?
Now, for Ubisoft, VR is the perfect technology for making gaming more accessible. And Ubisoft Montreal's Funhouse team built a game that just about everyone is going to know how to play the minute they put on their headsets. So, here to take us into the world of Eagle Flight, please welcome creative director Xiao Huto, along with two huge fans of the game, Palmer Luckey, inventor and founder of Oculus, and Jason Holtman, head of publishing at Oculus VR.
Big niggas. Big ass niggas. Is that the dude who was on the cover of the magazine? The cover of the magazine in the air, and he was all like...
And even more excited to have you guys to play with us. Thanks for having us. We're huge fans of Eagle Flight. It's a very, very intuitive game, and the flight mechanic is super innovative, and it gives you that real freedom of flying in VR. But most of all, it's just super fun, and by super fun, I mean, I can beat Palmer almost every time I play.
That's not true. But I mean, we've been playing this game for months at Oculus, and we've been getting pretty good at it. And so this is a really good chance for us to come and show everybody that we can.
He made fapping much better. Thank you for making such amazing fapping material.
Let's go. Let's go.
Hello, everyone. My name's Carsten Myhill, and I'm going to talk you through, for the first time ever at E3,
Silver, you like that? You like that?
VR. It's called Capture the Prey. And two teams of three will battle it out in the skies over Paris. Over here we have the
Ben
team, resplendent in their Hawaiian shirts, led by Palmer Luckey, Olivier, and Vicky. And the red team, led by Jason Holtman, with his two wingmen, Andre and Charlie. Rules are simple. It's a capture the flag game. And we will play best of three. So if we're ready to go, let's fly.
Hello, mate.
So we can see the first location of the prey, right there at the foot of the Eiffel Tower. and they have to take it to the nest to score a point. It's a bit like football. They have to work as a team, taking the object and bringing it to a goal. All right, maybe not the greatest analogy in the world, but you get the idea. Teamwork is key.
And they're all playing together in VR? That's amazing. That is fucking cool.
Paris has been reclaimed by nature. We can see the Champ de Mars overrun now with beautiful trees and undergrowth and nature and escaped animals from the zoo, like those giraffes over there. Olivier has the rabbit and is making his way over to the nest right now. He's trying to stay low, using shortcuts, weaving in and out of the trees, taking little alleyways and tunnels wherever he can, trying to stay out of
sight damn good.
Of his opponents who are trying to shoot him.
The game looks good.
Oh, and he's been hit by Andre. And the rabbit is down. Charlie's got it. So the red team in possession. Oh, no. Killed by Vicky. Who's going to pick it up? Damn, they're not far from the nest now.
Cock police saying, nigga, sit down. I ain't going to warn you again. I have to stretch. Otherwise, I'm going to have lower back pain.
Yeah. There's the nest.
I'm going to be real with you guys real quick. One main reason why I don't stream that often is because when I sit down for too long, because I'm so tall, I've always had lower back problems. So when I sit down, I don't move for too long, my back starts to really act up on me. And it's also because of the chair. This chair isn't as good as it used to be, and it's not comfortable anymore. So eventually, I have to save up money and buy a new chair because this one just isn't doing it for me. DX Racer's cool and all, but I'm a tall-ass nigga, man, and I need special accommodations, and oh well. So that's the reason why I don't really stream that often. So I'm thinking maybe if I stretch and keep myself mobile, I don't, you know, I won't run into those back pains. Hopefully I don't.
Staying low, Jason, being wingman, backing him up. Over to the Pantheon there. Oh, great kill by Jason on Olivier. Oh, no! But Andre has it for the red team, 1-1!
Yeah. Jake.
Don't high-five each other.
Jake, that's exactly what I do. Whenever I stream, I always have to lay down because my
right
back.
At the top of the Eiffel Tower. Don't ask me how the rabbit got up there.
Cabri missed.
Extremely exposed position.
It's good.
We'll see them shooting at each other as they head up to try and get that final.
I can tell you why kids love Cinnamon Toast Crunch, okay? I can tell you.
Palmer. And Andre's down. Great shot of Vicky taking him out there. Vicky inside the Eiffel Tower, utilizing the thermals.
Yeah, if you're tall and you've sat down for a long time, even if you're not tall, you understand where I'm coming from. That back pain. I envy other Twitch streamers. I envy other YouTube gaming streamers because they don't have the back pain. So they can sit down for hours, 12 hours, and not worry. Me, I sit down for 4 hours, my back.
Okay, we have to chase on to get to that final nest. Not far to go now.
They're going fucking fast, dude.
Andre with it for the red team. Taken out just at the final moment.
How tall are you, Etika? You're 6 feet, 6 inches tall.
And keep on playing. Sorry, guys, you're going to have to stop now. For those of you here, you can come to the Ubisoft booth and the Oculus booth to try it out yourselves. So we'd love to come and see you down there. Thanks very much. Have a
everyone
great
in chat, type Etika's back is a stupid nigger.
Thanks to Palmer and Jason, Charlie, and of course the entire dev team. I actually got to play an early version of this game last year at E3, and I'm not going to lie to you, it was like super alpha, and I peed a little. Like, it wasn't even very good, and it was awesome. So this is going to be incredible. I really encourage you to check it out. Eagle Flight is going to be on Oculus Rift and all the other VR platforms this fall, and it is playable this week at the Ubisoft and Oculus booth, so get down there and do it. Now that we've seen some flying raptors soaring through abandoned city streets, it's time to ascend a bit higher in elevation. So please welcome Ubisoft Red Storm's David Votivka.
At Ubisoft, VR is about more than just technology. It's about creating games that just weren't possible before, and exploring new worlds with friends without ever having to leave your living room. It's about fully immersing yourself in these worlds and going places and becoming people and doing things that you otherwise could not.
But only like 5% of people out there can purchase
today,
VR. It's so expensive.
VR is all about opening up the final frontier.
To rich niggas, a VR headset costs $600 to $800. You need a massively powerful gaming PC to run it at a acceptable frame rate. Meh. It's not bad to focus on it, though. And the reason why it's still holding on is because when you try it out, it's very good.
Captain's log. Stardate 2016.165. Starship USS Aegis.
I don't need no milk. Star Trek? We on some Star Trek shit right now? Star Trek VR.
We're en route to a secret testing facility and are proceeding to our destination at maximum warp.
This is amazing!
Wow!
Absolutely astonishing.
When I walked in, I really wasn't sure what I was actually walking into.
This is Yo, they got the old school!
Imagine what I would
Yo.
Want the Star Trek VR game to be.
Damn, he's getting old.
This is what we've been waiting for.
Oh my god, they got them all there!
Holy crap, this is amazing.
I mean, this really is breathtaking.
That was an extraordinary experience.
Yo, are you kidding me?
Encompassed.
He doesn't know he aged at all.
With each other, and you're talking to each other, and you're taking orders from the captain, and you're, I mean, it's really cool.
So there's captain, helm,
yeah.
Meeting rainbow! And of course, Star Trek.
I'm feeling pressure already. I'm feeling nervous now.
All right, shields up. Prepare warp. Take us out.
Yes, captain.
And they have the thoughts?
Game playing is not new. I mean, you know, we can play games with our friends, but there's something different about being in a shared virtual environment.
Hearing who you're playing with, you can look over and see the person and see them doing their job and talk to them.
The team does not succeed unless everybody does their job well.
Ship decloaking, activating shields.
Okay, shields up.
Shields up.
I really did not want to lower the shields. While we were under attack, I was very impressed by LeVar playing that game today. He really had the language of Star Trek down.
And they are transporting, Captain.
It's like, this makes you push the buttons.
I will say, I nailed being the engineer.
It's like he never left the show. He never left. Yo!
It's a Klingon. Red alert.
Preparing to warp.
We're under attack. We have been waiting in anticipation for so long for the technology of virtual reality to catch up with where we imagine we should be and where we all want to go.
ABHD saying, until we get Sword Art Online technology, VR isn't worth it just yet. Oh man, the day Sword Art Online technology becomes a real thing, sign me up.
Your own Star Trek experience in a virtual world where you can hang out with whoever you want, and that's a pretty good deal.
Yeah, I'm streaming the Treehouse tomorrow. Guaranteed streaming the Treehouse tomorrow. Even though I'm not interested in the Treehouse, I still want to see what they do. Okay, donations
guys,
are going
Ubisoft
off for now.
You the
going
first
off,
ever
but they'll come back.
Star Trek VR game, as
they'll
you can
back.
See, it's amazing, and you heard it here first. Unless, of course, you heard it from the reporter who leaked it on Reddit. You know what you can suck a bag of, ladies and gentlemen. Here is the man who was rocking a VR headset way before VR even existed, Mr. LeVar Burton.
Whenever she does something edgy, I drink. After this stream, tweet out to Aisha Taylor and tell her that she personally saw to it that I got fucked up on this stream.
Thank you so much.
Personally.
So it looks like Ubisoft got some of the old Trek band back together. I mean, like all of the old Trek bands and the new ones back together. So I have two questions for you. First of all, I know you have my email, so why no invite? But we'll talk about that after. And how did the game compare to being on the actual Enterprise?
So here's the thing, right? We use our imaginations so much, right, when you're on the set. You guys know that.
When you're operating the console, it's really not connected to anything. You knew that, right?
You're breaking all our hearts
right
now.
I know. But here's the thing. You don't have to imagine in this game. You are existing in a completely rendered environment. You are on the bridge of a starship, and you're with your friends. Oh. It's pretty cool.
It's so amazing. So
that is incredible.
What was it like working with
it? Looked a little slow, but when you're in there, I know it's something totally different.
It's not real. Okay, yeah, I know.
But it feels real. Yeah. I mean, it felt real to us when we were doing it. Look, playing with Carl and Jerry was amazing because, you know, we have this special bond that just like you will with your friends when you play. And here's the thing. We really had to work together to accomplish the mission. And what's more Star Trek than that? I mean,
everyone wants Raymond.
The engineer, or you can
take a look.
You can
it's
be
in our book.
You can be the captain, but no
reading
one
rainbow
more than any other. Everybody has to do their level best in order to get the job done, and that's at the core of what Star Trek has always been about.
Right, and what people love about cooperative.
Did they show Watchdogs?
Absolutely.
Not yet.
So when you were Geordi LaForge, you were the engineer.
Yes.
But in the game, you got to be the captain. So what did that feel like?
Oh, well, God.
I told the guys at Red Storm that I was not going to shave my head for the privilege.
Jake, it's just the Nintendo's just doing a treehouse. No digital event. No live broadcast. Just no live presentation.
It was
just
weird how I just sort of
treehouse
into Geordi. It was like that skin. I just like put it right back on again. The lingo, the rhythm, the techno babble. It all started clicking in, coming back.
Sponsors,
but
come on.
I'm used to like responding.
Oh God, sponsors. What is this two for?
The order. So I had to like, oh yeah.
Two for Etika to drink. Oh God, Jen. Oh God.
That's how we start this thing.
So, I'm already.
It took a moment, but I got the hang of it.
Oh God, fuck
it's such a blast.
Spawns hype.
Nailed it.
Spawn type.
Everything is so beautiful. Oh. But you will forget all of that because the gameplay is so engaging.
God, it's so cool.
It's
well,
awesome.
I can't wait to play this game, preferably at your house.
Yes. Well, you can come over and then we can play. We can play with like Brent and Jonathan Frakes and Michael
on.
Dorn.
What are you doing with my feelings right now?
No. Won't that be cool, though?
Yes, it would be cool. I don't want to burst into tears in the middle of this conference, so I'll just cry it out with you after. But thank you so much for talking about with us today. You are dismissed.
But you can't dismiss me unless you outrank me.
It's very clear that I don't outrank you by like many levels, so I will just say, make it so, number one.
I love you.
Oh, I love you, too.
Oh, my God. Guys. LeVar Burton, everybody! LeVar Burton! Okay, so we've all imagined ourselves on that bridge, and now you get to do it. We're going to have Star Trek Bridge Crew at the Ubisoft booth, and of course, when it comes out this fall on all major VR
Take
systems.
A look. It's in that book. Reading niggas. I can read anything. Stars will glow. Find them hoes. Reading rainbows.
It came without warning.
The fuck is this? Oh God. Oh. Alright, niggas are getting fucked up. What is this? Dudes in the chat are still building walls. Donald Trump is in the chat still. What is it, Skyrim? Yeah, that's Skyrim. That's that Fools Will Die nigga, right? Maybe not. Sorin Noctis. What's going on, Sorin? Is this Dank Souls?
Perhaps we had a chance for peace. But desperation and trust are seldom allies.
What in the hell is going on? Oh my god. This is definitely not Dark Souls.
A thousand years of war.
Holy shit. Damn. Jesus.
The reason they fight, lost to the ages. And yet, here they still stand.
What?
Searching for a sign.
What the hell is going on, man? Shits.
I am Apollyon. I bring war.
What the hell? Yo! That was epic, but we haven't seen gameplay yet.
Desperation drives us to war.
That looked amazing.
It is trust that can end it. Apollyon and her Blackstone legions crave a world where trust is impossible and the wolves among us can roam free. I'm Jason Vandenberg. I'm the creative director on For Honor. Last year, in our multiplayer reveal, we gave you the chance to experience our new melee combat system, the art of battle. Now, we welcome you to the world of For Honor.
For Honor.
In our campaign, be knighted. Join the Blackstone.
I love his enthusiasm,
dude. Drive your enemies from your lands. As a samurai, unite your people to prevent a civil war and restore the prestige of the Empire.
What's some gameplay?
And as a Viking, well, I think it's better to just show you.
Let's see, baby.
I'd like you to meet...
Let's see.
I'd like you to meet our game director on For Honor, Roman Campos Oriola. Come on out, Roman. Yes. My brother. You are the raider. In the aftermath of war, your people were starving. You brought them back. Now, your fleet sails for the lands of the samurai in seeking plunder and glory.
Yo.
Apollyon's war had taken us to the edge of extinction. But that raider reminded us of who we are. We would raid, but not Apollyon. Not yet. But they knew we were coming.
The guy has an awesome voice. Yeah, he does. Oh shit. The what? How are you even supposed to get past that? How did they get past the spikes in the water? Those niggas don't fuck around, dude.
Through the gates. I welcome you all. The gates of that fortress hadn't worked for a century.
Yo.
All we had to do was get through them.
I see people getting knocked off right there, dude. Oh, you can help niggas out. Okay, we got some Dynasty Warriors kind of shit in here. Not bad. I like it. I like it. Oh, he's fucking him up. Like a mini boss? Oh! Oh, he's done. Damn! Yeah, we ain't exactly Dynasty Warriors. This is fucking visceral right here. Done.
That wall was the only way forward.
Get over here. This game looks fucking serious. Ooh.
Call the rope launchers.
Ropes! Grapples!
Yo! You seeing the way his head is like all bloodied and shit? Never mind, that nigga's done. Yo, you do not want that boy inside of your castle, man. I don't even think he really needs the army, to be honest with you. That nigga by himself is OP as hell. They're shooting arrows at them and shit. Yeah, that'd be the smartest idea, man.
One warrior made it to the top. One would be enough.
One nigga? You're not telling me this nigga's about to run through the whole fucking castle. He's not about to run through the whole castle by himself. What kind of fucking Game Shark cheat code does this nigga have on right now? Nigga's got an Iron Maiden just chilling there? He's by himself, dog. Oh my god.
The raider got us inside that fort.
Now we have them.
Hidden blade type shit. Damn. That's his own person. He hit his own teammate? That nigga needs a nerf. Uh-oh. That's one of the real niggas right there.
My fortress is lost. My soldiers slaughtered. Soon, I will join them. You open the gate. Now, you will pay.
Oh my god, that nigga's the Shogun right there. This is not a joke, dog. Oh, he broke his shield? Is this dude about to get washed on stage at E3 in his own game? Damn. Oh my god. He's dead as fuck. What is that nigga made of?
That raider showed us what Viking fury could do. Jeez. A great raid, they would call it. And it had begun.
Yo! For honor, dog. For honor! Nigga ran through the cat. He didn't even give up. He just.
If you are looking for something to give that very special someone in your life, For Honor will be available on Valentine's Day.
Really?
Sweet. It's a nice gesture.
Yeah, real
sweet.
More
romantic than dinner, drinks, and an all-night bender of epic warfare. Either you'll bond forever, or she'll move out in the morning.
Yep.
And if you're
hey, fuck
LA,
her. She moves out. You don't need her. She don't know good games.
Now, for those of you watching at home, head to ForHonorGame.com to register for the very next alpha that will come very soon. All right? Now, here to talk about catapulting of a completely different kind, please welcome producer at Ubisoft Reflections, Pete Young.
What's going on, Pete? Hey, guys, give Pete one of these. My man, Petey. What's up, dude? Hope you're chilling, Pete.
At Ubisoft, we Hello? Get to tell all kinds of stories. Like how we can go from a massive AAA game like For Honor to a wobbly red robot in a small experimental game. Last year, we surprised you and ourselves with Grow Home, the story of our little robot bud learning how to experience the world around him.
Okay.
And today, I'm really excited to announce that bud is back. And this time, he's not just growing home, he's growing up.
Be back. Be back.
In Grow Up, Bud will take his first stumbling steps without the watchful eye of Mom. And you'll get to stretch your acrobatic skills across an entire planetary playground. Not only can you ride the giant star plants,
but you
can throw down seeds and use plants to bounce, shoot, and catapult yourself to new heights, all the way to the moon. We want you to help Bud grow up this August on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One. Thank you, and enjoy E3.
So I missed a lot of that. Hopefully, I don't look like too much of an asshole. But hey, I just wasn't
Pete,
all that interested in that
so
one.
So adorable, you could forget to say anything at all, and just turn those vowels into words way up. There were like 18 A's in that word. You're awesome. Now, at its core, Ubisoft is a creative company with an independent spirit, and support for innovative projects is a part of its DNA. But every once in a while, that DNA mutates slightly, and this happens.
Here something brand new. Ubisoft creative director, tag team champions.
So what's this? Someone said Jacksepticeye? What do you mean? More Just Dance? Please, no more. I can't take any more Just Dance. Was that the Mortal Kombat remix? I think that's the Mortal Kombat remix.
Thank you. Where's Chad? Not you. Out.
It's fucking Keemstar?
No, I'm sorry.
How the hell DJ Keemstar got in on a fucking Ubisoft
Hello.
Conference?
I'm Antti Levasseur, the creative director.
Etika, get the bleach. Way ahead of you.
President of Finland.
Give him a hand.
Hello.
Give him a hand.
I'm the creative director of the original Blood Dragon. And advocate of war peace.
Yeah.
Trials and Blood Dragon made baby together. That's right, Antti. And this horrible problem child is being delivered right now. Now.
So what is this? Let's pay attention.
Rex Power Cult and Dr. Darling are back, this time with their two Cyber Commando kids, Roxanne and Slater. Play as the rattliest mean humans this side of Mars, and defy gravity on your ultimate Dragon Slayer.
What's going on? This looks like some Adult Swim type jump off, man.
Roller coaster of righteousness.
Are things about to get too many cooks in here? Wow.
Face is the place, and the action is in your face. Ride through loops, hoops, and multiple dimensions.
They made a game that has just as much cringe as the conference itself. How in the fuck did Ubisoft manage that?
Together, forever, today.
Is this Trials?
Trials of the Blood Dragon.
This is the racing game, the one where, well, it's not racing. The motorcycle, when you try to like get the good flips, and you try to do as many tricks as you can in the air. Trials, I remember this game. I played it a lot on the PlayStation 3 with my friend Ben. Him and I used to play that shit a lot whenever I visited him.
Nothing like an 8-bit title to get you excited. As you can tell, this game is a beast, and in case you didn't get the incredibly subtle messaging in that video, it is out now on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One. Well, actually, it's almost out now. We didn't want anybody sprinting off to chase Blood Dragons while we were still here on stage. So the game will be released as soon as this conference ends, about 30 minutes from now. Calm yourselves and just take comfort in the fact that apparently LMFAO is back together, guys. So that was nice. All right.
Oh, really?
Guys, never knew they were white. Guys.
My nigga Rad Red.
This is Ubisoft. And there is, yes it is, my friends, and there is no UBE3 experience without a deep dive into Assassin's Creed. You
oh,
know
really?
This, and I know this.
So we're
and
about to see some
A-Creed?
And this
year is special because Assassin's Creed is about to go super multi-platform. Here to talk
really?
About the upcoming Assassin's Creed movie, please join me in welcoming legendary movie producer Frank Marshall.
I guess we knew they couldn't really go without talking anything about Assassin's Creed, so I mean, hey, whatever, I mean, it's not a new game, so for me, it's okay. I just really want them to take time off with Assassin's Creed,
Frank,
the game,
so
and just work on it.
Sure.
But the movie?
Today.
Sure,
now,
why not?
Case, yeah, I'm excited to have you. In case people don't know, you have worked on some of the hugest films and film franchises that have ever existed in our history. Indiana Jones, Back to the Future, the Bourne films, Jurassic World. So what drew you specifically to this project?
Well, I think, I mean, it's kind of...
You know who he looks like? He looks like that dude from the
And I thought from the stock images, the Assassin's Creed universe really had all the elements that can make a great movie. So it was kind of our goal as the filmmakers to take these elements and stay respectful to the franchise and the DNA of the brand and bring something new to the franchise.
He looks like this nigga.
That could be experienced in movie theaters. So we have a new story. We have a new hero, dynamic supporting players and characters. So we kind of mixed a little bit of the old up and the familiar.
He bears resemblance to that old man.
And this is such a story franchise.
I'm just saying, he does.
I think everybody is super stoked to see that Michael
just without the beard
is playing in the lead role. Yes. Yeah, it's an incredible cast all around.
Silver says, I know who you mean.
Well,
I know who you
really
mean.
Kind of a massive production. We shot in...
Like, he about to have a heart attack on stage. It's fucked up.
Four different countries. Obviously, there's an historical aspect to the story where we go back in time, just like in the game. But we really wanted to get the right team.
We don't go back in time.
We started with our director.
We go into the Animus, all right?
Fantastic director.
Say it like it is.
Named Justin Kurzel.
I'm playing around. I'm playing around. I'm being an asshole.
Just worked with Mr. Fassbender on Macbeth. And he's really a true visionary who understands the best elements of the game and how to translate them into the movie. Then we assembled a team of really...
Nintendo isn't announcing anything new, though, I think.
Surround him with.
I don't think they're announcing anything brand new, guys.
The world and using these real...
The Trials game is on Steam right now, really?
...team of stunt experts to take us into the parkour and the
MNK Gaming, why he got a fruit roll-up on his shirt. Are you serious, my boy? A fruit roll-up on his shirt? MNK, come on, bro.
Given all of that,
come on, bro.
Excited about seeing when they see Assassin's Creed on the screen.
Well, I think there's a lot to look forward to. But really, it's the multi-layered mythology that we have that comes from the game. And the
kind of putting it
into the story. We have a real story, and it has an arc that goes all the way to the end.
He got that fruit roll up on his shirt.
Being able to have that same wish fulfillment you have in the game, of being able to see the world through the lives and the ancestors.
Why does he have it? Because 50 people were shot in a gay club in the biggest mass shooting in the United States history yesterday. That's why he's got the fruit roll up on.
To kind of right niggas. And bring people in is an interesting challenge, but obviously a really great opportunity.
Why they got this dude with this sex toy over here?
So people are expecting huge reveals. We want secrets. We want dirt. What magical things can you reveal?
So Nintendo is announcing something today? Guarantee?
No, actually...
At 5:30, huh?
I can show you...
All right, so if Nintendo is announcing something today, then send me the link to it on Twitter right now.
An exclusive video that gives you a sneak peek behind the curtain and shows you everything that went into making this film, as well as never be seen before footage from the movie. So we're going to roll that video very soon, as soon as you give the word, right?
As soon as I throw to it. Well, thank you so much for being here today.
My pleasure.
Assassin's Creed is going to be in theaters December 21st. So play a lot of Assassin's Creed before then, so it's all inside of you when you go to see the movie. And now,
it's all inside.
For your viewing enjoyment, I present... Mr. Michael Fassbender.
Yuki, what the fuck? Yuki, what the fuck is this? I don't want to know the details of what the hell that encompasses, okay, Yuki? That movie, though. I don't want to know what Hillary's rocking with.
The assassins.
Her daughter? But I don't know. I know what Hillary rocks.
And their main rivals are Templars. The Templars are trying to enhance human.
Hey, listen. The only reason why I'm not paying full attention to this is because I know Assassin's Creed backwards and forwards, like my fucking masturbating hand. Nothing here is new to me, but it's interesting to see the movie's development. But I've seen a lot about it already. So I mean.
You're
lost. And why do Animus look like that?
He's starts to learn that he comes from a lineage of assassins.
He realizes the true history of himself, and he creates a kind of revolution.
We work in the dark to serve the light. We are assassins.
Michael is one of the greatest actors of his generation, and there's many other strong characters in the film.
I don't want to leave the Ubisoft conference, though. That's the thing.
Experience. Action sequences are massive.
I just want it to be an unbelievable ride.
You have to show him who he really is.
Okay, so here's what I'm seeing, guys. All right, so the Nintendo announcement, the Nintendo stream that's happening later today, it's only for indie titles, okay? So if it's only exactly indie, I don't think it's anything worth missing the Ubisoft conference over, you know what I mean? But there could be some games there, so I have to choose and pick. I don't know if I'll be able to be at both of these. We'll just do the Ubisoft for now, guys. But it's just indie, you know? Just indie. Not the big titles that we want, the small ones.
Now for our next game.
Yep, here we go. Watch Dogs 2, baby. Let's go. Now that's what I'm talking about, baby. Give me that. Sheikah Bane. What's going on, Sheikah Bane Star? Thank you for joining the sponsor group. I like that McCree avatar. Hopefully you'll still be able to use him after he gets nerfed, man. Thank you.
Is the single most powerful population control tool ever created. Defend democracy. Help us tear down Infra. Lend us your processing power by downloading our app, and together, we will expose Congressman Thruss. Join us. We are DedSec.
Damn, bro. Here we go. My boy Marcus is about to put in some work, man. I'm excited for this, guys.
Hello, everyone, and welcome into the San Francisco Bay Area, the birthplace of the tech revolution and Watch Dogs 2's new playground.
This time, I love this guy.
You will join DedSec, a hacker group rebelling against an establishment that uses technology to take away our freedom. You are Marcus Holloway, a brilliant young hacker on a mission to take back control from the establishment. Now, we all live in a hyper-connected world. Everything we use and every one of us is connected through technology. From the perspective of a hacker, this world is filled with opportunities. So in Watch Dogs 2, everything around you can be hacked in creative ways. You can also profile, manipulate, and hack everyone. Wow. And you're not alone. You can seamlessly encounter other DedSec hackers. And now, getting into co-op has never been simpler.
Isn't that the same nude that we saw from the reveal trailer, too? Well, the reveal.
Let's deal with Invite.
The reveal event?
A social media giant that's just been exposed by DedSec.
Our numbers are going through the roof, but we just promised we'll have a lid open on Empire.
And we'll deliver. Have faith, sister.
Sure. If we can find evidence that Empire's manipulating social media.
Prince, where you at, man?
Scouting Congressman Gibson's apartment from the Rupert store. Oh, we fucked up this fundraiser. Almost everyone's gone. Come on, get over here.
Okay, people. This is strictly by the book. Don't paint outside the lines and stay frosty.
Fuck you.
Stay frosty.
Don't give them that five to Rusty Nails or just five for us to the social media for us.
On my way.
Only racist. Only father for Johnson and Johnson.
The Bay Area is filled with stories you can choose to explore. But for now, let's just check what happens when that second filtrate the politicians found out to find evidence that Ed White might have helped.
I can't hear him too well.
Election.
You need to turn up his volume.
Check it out. You can see the whole city from here.
Whole lot of people out there, man. Whole lot of people.
Yeah. Please don't tell me he betrays you and you have to kill him at some point in the game. That would fucking suck. Are you kidding me?
No. It's fucked up.
I want those.
I know it's gonna be a hell of a fight turning them back into people.
Fucking A, man.
How old is this Marcus, dude?
You find the evidence, and I'll monitor exit strategy.
Franklin is back. Shofu? My nigga Shofu made it into Watch Dogs 2. Shofu, congrats, man. That's my fucking boy right there. Finally.
Marcus, the building just went off the grid.
My nigga Shofu, man.
They're up to something.
That's that nigga damage right there. Big time props, man. How'd they get Shofu in this? Oh man, my nigga Shofu made it into Watch Dogs. That is so cool. I would just put a handgun on that bitch, just start shooting niggas.
They got armed help in there. Something's definitely up.
I loved being able to do that in Watch Dogs, man. To just be able to go camera surfing.
Get us access, Marcus, before it all gets wiped.
I'll get you inside the system. Once I do, you use the botnet to brute force your way in and download everything you can.
But once you start downloading, they'll know you're inside.
It wouldn't be a party if they didn't. And I've got a surprise for them.
Oh my god.
Where are we on wiping the Congress of the Cloud?
That's done, but there's a team at Invite scrubbing the backups, too.
They're good at this.
They're the best computer forensics team we have. You pay top dollar, you get top talent.
That's what I want to hear.
Rich, you ready for my exit strategy?
Define! Ready!
Nigga said it was a Smash announcement, Lyra? Let's make the Bay Area great again. Trust is Trump. It's confirmed, dog. So they put Shofu, they put Donald Trump. Who's next? Brittany Venti?
Yo, Satoru, I'm ready to go in.
Satoru. Oh boy. What in the hell is gonna happen? I think Watch Dogs' initial combat, stealth system in Watch Dogs was better than any Assassin's Creed game. They tried their best to translate it to Unity initially, and I feel like it didn't work that well. But Watch Dogs, the original, the stealth system was so good. And I feel like the aiming system was solid as hell too, man. Overall, Watch Dogs, I feel like it was a great adaptation for modern times with Assassin's Creed, man. That nigga Trump is right on the TV. Don't sweat the technique, man. Oh shit. That nigga Marcus. He's as smooth as it gets.
Yo,
And trust me, guys, I don't think you have to worry about the graphics or Ubisoft line or the E3 filter. Nah. We're good now. Can you make that car drive, dude? How many toys does this nigga have? Oh god, no. Yo, he's hacking the Wii U? He about to put some Smash mods on there?
You're in. Do your thing.
Oh my god. Shofu doesn't give a fuck. That nigga's right in there. He didn't even kill anybody.
You're in a line of fire.
One thing I loved about the original Watch Dogs 2 is its difficulty. The game is actually pretty damn tough. The visuals of this game are insane. Yo, dude, are you serious? Yo, how are you running from the cops? Yo, that was amazing. That was amazing! I thought that I wouldn't like the stylistic change from more of a funky, you know, popping kind of way from the dark themes of the original Watch Dogs, but I'm loving it! Oh my god! That nigga Shofu went in! Wait, did she say PC? Did she say PC? Well, I gotta go back.
PC.
So, PC release? Oh, baby. Give it to me. Oh, give it to me. Give it to me, baby. I want it on PC. That's phenomenal, EE. It's Shofu and EE. They're both featuring in the game. They just switch every now and then.
Thank you for being with us today. So, as you may remember, when we launched the first time Watch Dogs with the PS4, it was a major success. And that was really thanks to Sony and the push they did have
really?
On this game. So
it was really buggy, but
I'm very happy to tell you that we are going to continue with Sony and we are going to do Watchdog 2 with them. So I would like to ask Tim from Sony to come with us and tell you more about it. Thank you.
Uh-oh. Is this a big nigga too?
Thank you, Jim.
Sony.
Hello, Jim. Welcome.
Thanks, Eve. That's right. We've been really impressed by Watch Dogs ever since Ubisoft first showed the game right here back in 2012. I think you were there that night. Sony and Ubisoft partnered on that game in the early days of the PlayStation 4. And then our partnership went even further. A while back, Sony Pictures Entertainment signed up with Ubisoft Motion Pictures to produce a Watch Dogs feature film with New Regency Productions.
Really?
After
movie?
What is shaping up to be an amazing Assassin's Creed film, we think Watch Dogs is set to be the next video game-based blockbuster movie. Yeah.
It's
really?
An incredibly filmic game. Yeah, it looks so cool. And,
so, okay, if you're doing a Watch Dogs movie, you legit
it's
have to get Shofu to play the part at this point. Like, there's no other actor you should consider but Shofu.
Looking at the character and I'm thinking
the hat, too?
Jordan
oh, my
or
God.
Or Tay Diggs or and Aisha Tyler, who is tall and black and slightly masculine. That's what I'm thinking, you know, yeah?
Slightly masculine? What you talking about, girl?
I'll be waiting.
Slightly masculine, my ass. Just because you got some big hands.
Also brought something very special to share with our PlayStation.
That girl's still cute.
That's right.
She's still cute.
PlayStation owners will have access to all Watch Dogs 2 DLCs 30 days before they're released on any other platform.
Wow.
PlayStation? Okay.
That's a killer deal for the PlayStation Nation. Thank you.
That's big.
Thank you so
That's
much,
pretty big.
Jim. And now we're going to take
Justin
one more look
with
at
Le Pepe
the
as his avatar.
Playground.
What's going on, Justin? Thank you for coming through, man. I appreciate it. And the link to the sponsor chat is in the description, so use that to go fuck with us on that level if you want.
Ah, the San Francisco Bay.
Damn, she was kind of thick. Bruh. Yo. Really? Son, why is this so hype? Ah, man, this is so cool! Watch Dogs 2! Damn, nigga! And that yo, he has the 8 ball on a stick? Oh, and we got a cutie on the team too, of course. Son, Watch Dogs, oh my god, oh my god, woohoo, Watch Dogs 2, baby,
literally
oh my god,
hacker in the world.
That nigga Shoku is molding out here,
few good robots.
Oxymoron,
so
oxymoron, oh thank you so much, joining the sponsor
group. Jr., a hack security robot from the game. It's probably not going to help you oust a corrupt corporate overlord with a stranglehold on your city, but it is radio controlled and so quite useful for annoying your coworkers and ending unwanted relationships.
Great. Thank you.
All right, folks.
Thank you so much, Oxymoron, for coming through.
Today, and we all know that Eve likes to be the one to announce the next thing. So I'll let him take it away. Ladies and gentlemen.
So, okay, last announcement, guys. Sit down. Grab your seat, and should we grab our lotion? I don't know if we should grab the lotion yet.
So I'm excited to tell you about our new IP from our studio in the French house. The studio has a lot of multiplayer expertise.
We got something new here, man.
Those guys have done
Splinter
Cell multiplayer.
Okay.
They have done also Assassin's Creed multiplayer, and they worked on the Division,
Rayman?
On some part of the
they
game.
They said new IP.
So
I don't think it's Rayman. They said something brand new,
the
man.
The thrill of action sports
let's
a
see.
Truly explorable open world. So this
action
game
sports?
Will give you a chance to challenge your friends and to share your adventures with the community.
It's I would a love a new Rayman.
New genre, and I am sure you will love it. Thank you.
If they come out with raving rabbits, I'm gonna stab somebody. I'm gonna stab a nigga if I see a fucking raving rabbit. New IP though, guys.
It's that moment where I've committed to leaving, but I haven't left the earth yet. Nothing you can do but charge forward.
What I love the most in the mountains is that I can do anything I want. It's pure freedom.
You know, there's always a bit of fear. If you don't have a little fear, you know, then you're a little crazy, I think.
Tony Hawk Pro Skate? No.
Nothing else matters up here. All the chaos is just gone. No one else around.
The moment my feet leave the earth, everything else disappears.
Got my own monster.
It's pure adrenaline. Nobody
what kind of gameplay would this make? That's what I'm curious about. What is this category of, what is it called? Hang gliding? I don't know if that's the exact name. GoPro, really? Sell out, boys?
The mountain is your canvas, you know? You can paint your own picture. That's what the beauty of it is.
The most important thing for me is to try something that never been done before.
Am I scared? Sure. But fear can be a tool.
So what are we looking at? Are we looking at,
performing beyond what you think your limits are?
Are we looking at this game right here? SSX Tricky? Type a 1 in the chat if you know what SSX Tricky is, because that's what it's looking like to me. That SSX Tricky right there. That was an old game, dude. I don't know if you guys know about it. Steep. Y'all niggas know about that SSX? I see.
Alright,
I guess you're more informed than I thought. You're more informed than I gave you credit for.
We are from Ubisoft Annecy at the base of the Alps, just a few miles from the tallest peak in Europe, Le Mont Blanc. From our studio windows, we are surrounded by the mountains, and they have inspired us to develop the game that we're here to show you today.
SSX Tricky right there.
Up in this mountain,
steep SS.
Sports isn't always about winning. Sometimes, it's just about doing awesome things with your friends and living life.
Jetpack X says, whoa, nigga, I remember. That's a throwback, isn't it, Jet? That's a throwback.
Sharing them with your friends. Let's show some gameplay. Take it away, Igor.
Thank you.
Let's see how this game plays. I don't know if I'm too interested in it, but hey, new IP, Ubisoft. Rayman better be playable.
That's good.
Bato says, I'll just go in the mountain in real life instead.
Welcome to the world.
Justin says, this seems like a stupid game.
A massive open world, partially set in the Alps, at the intersection of
maybe it'll
Italy,
surprise us, man.
Austria,
you never know.
Switzerland,
maybe.
And France. We're currently flying over Aiguille du Mont Blanc. And in case you're wondering, aiguille means needles.
R.I.P. Rayman, replaced for snowboards
first thing we'll
and skis.
Do is land on a small
yeah, Rayman hasn't
there.
Gotten too much love.
And notice the
Rayman Origins,
right.
And that's basically it, right? After Rayman Origins, we didn't
Walking
really hear much.
That's another player from the community.
Come on, Ubisoft, stop fucking up. Let me get a pillow for my back. My back. My neck. My back. My pussy and my crap.
From here, we can now enjoy the view and observe the world around us. The big guy in front of you is the Mont Blanc, the biggest summit in the region. And in the distance, you can see the Matterhorn, one of the wildest spots in the game. And on the right, you've got the Aravis Range, the region we come from, where Ubisoft and
okay.
C stand.
They had a GoPro
Instead,
parachute.
We
they have
really
a target
cool
backpack.
Tool. We call it Mountain really? View. Mountain View allows you to zoom out from your position, observe the world, and navigate into the environment. Our mountain range will be populated by drop zones. Drop
back.
Zones are entry points for you to drop in the world when you're ready. Now, let's get back to our initial position. Besides drop zones, the game will offer a wide range of challenges for you to test your skills. The one in front of us is a wingsuit activity. And as the other player drops in, we'll follow him and trigger the challenge. This is a proximity flying race challenge.
Oh my god. I know it's a game, but like looking at this shit gets me nervous a little bit. There's people that do this shit in real life, and all it would take is just one bad angle or a gust of wind in the wrong direction and bam. Everything just your life snuffed out. Oh my god! This looks crazy. I can't lie, dude. This looks fucking hype. Would I ever do this in real life? Fuck no! I wish I could, but I'd just be too scared of fucking dying. I'll only do this when I'm like 50 years old and I've accomplished everything that I've wanted in my life. You know? Oh, he's dead. He's dead. Nope, that's it. That's it for me. I will never do this ever.
We just secured the silver medal, and
unless
there,
I have nothing else to live.
We could choose to move onto skiing in the Aiguille. But we'd like to introduce you to another region. So let's switch to Mountain View, and head over to Aravis.
Like, if I ever do this, I have to make sure, if anyone ever does this, make sure that you've done everything that you wanted in your life and all your goals are complete. So when if you die on this bitch, you're happy.
To show you what it's like to play online with your friends or with other players from the community.
The death is real. VR for this game? Oh my god. Oh my god. Flying with feathers. VR on this would be insane. It's probably really possible too. It doesn't look like it's meant for an FPS kind of view though, but I'm sure VR would still work.
As you ride, you will keep meeting other players from the community.
Right, on time, it's tricky.
Let's switch our point of view to follow Hoon's riders.
Oh, they got a first-person view too. Never mind.
As you noticed, the game will support GoPro views.
GoPro has their dick all up in this game. They're like balls deep in the mouth of this shit. But it looks cool. I'm not gonna lie, dude. Look at how amazing this is. Yo.
Hold on. We really need to pose here. Oh my god. Now I'd like to show you something special. If we go back to Mountain
View. Are you kidding me?
Take a look at that trail. Every line you do in the world creates a trail. And that trail is really cool. It not only allows you to check what you've done on your ride, so you can analyze your line, but it also
how do you go down the mountain like
what you've seen and what you've done.
This is amazing. Yo, how do you not break your fucking knees?
You can rewind. Pause. Control the camera.
Oh my god.
Go slow-mo.
Someone died there.
And follow any players you've met. And the idea here is to allow you to push that replay of your performances.
This is insane. Oh, he's dead. He's dead.
To all social networks so you can share it with the
world. What a shame.
Even better. Not only can you share videos, but say you liked that jump over the cliff. You know it's a tricky one. You can push it as a challenge to your friends. You define the rule, share it so it becomes part of the content your friends will see in their game.
That's pretty cool.
But let's catch up with our red paraglider.
Yo. I like it. So every single person that you're seeing right there is an actual friend. This looks like it would be a blast to play with other people, dude. I'm loving this right now. Holy fucking nigger. If only you could respawn like that in real life, then I wouldn't mind trying it, but nah, nigga, one of those and that's it. You giving up something. You giving up walking, you giving up fucking, probably both.
Steep is definitely about sharing intense, thrilling, crazy, or just pure fun moments. And it's also about enjoying the mountains.
No more back pain on this bitch, yeah. Steep though. Not bad. Not bad at all. I like it. I like it. Yo, guys. Give a clap if you
thank
like
you
it. I liked it. I'm gonna give a clap.
Thank you. We're inviting you all onto the mountain as soon as tomorrow.
The mountain
will be fully playable on the show floor. If you're watching from home, please visit steepgame.com to register for
chance
to participate in Steep Beta Phase.
A bunch of plays.
This game ships this December. Thank you very much.
This December? All right,
hey, guys. We got a lot done today, and we are barreling towards the finish line. But before we go, we want to bring Ubisoft CEO Yves Guillemot and all of the teams behind the games
Guillemot.
We had on stage during our show back out here one more time. Come on out, everybody. This is going to be like the end of Saturday Night Live, only all the game devs have not been drinking for hours. Although I'm sure they'll start very soon. Welcome, Yves.
Daft is good, says, not my kind of game, but it doesn't look bad. Just not like a hit. I hear you. Is it a hit? Who knows? But it looks like it'll be fun to try at least a couple times with friends. It looked like it might get old after a while, but who knows?
So those guys are going to give you a lot more.
So Ubisoft's performance is a 7 out of 10. Yeah, I'll give him a 6.5. No, actually, no. 7 out of 10 is good. 7.5. That's good. Etika, give me a thrust from Beer Brawler. Beer.
All the passion they have. I would like also to thank you, all the gamers. We are only here because of you. Awesome. We really love you guys because you always push us for excellence.
Ubisoft does love us, that's for
sure. As Aisha said, this year, Ubisoft celebrates our 30 years birthday. That means 30 years in the best industry in the world. I love video games because the real innovation and magic happens when our teams and players are free to create, free to innovate, free to express themselves, free to take risks and have fun. That's what got us here today, and that is what will drive us for another 30 years and beyond.
Yeah, Aisha doesn't seem like she went off the handle this time. I mean, she was still making jokes, but she wasn't as, okay. I guess she felt like
because
being more passive with the jokes.
When you are free, there is no failure. There is only forward.
Indeed. What the hell is this? Showing some of the titles. Oh, Rayman, sorry, bro. No love for my boy Rayman this year.
Ah, shit, we got the wrong game.
Very cool. Very, very cool.
All right, guys.
Damn, to be honest with you guys.
You were amazing today. Thanks for making this such a special conference. Stick around for our post show where we're going to answer your burning questions about Ubisoft and our conference today. Everybody, you've been so awesome. I'm Aisha Tyler. We are Ubisoft. Happy 30th birthday, Ubi. And you guys, you know what to do. Come on down. Meet us on the floor. And do that shit.
Do that shit. Let's go, Aisha. I was hoping that she wouldn't lose enthusiasm because of people criticizing her or anything, but nah, she still seems as funky as ever. Alright, guys, so that about wraps it up for the Ubisoft conference, I think. UB30, let's go. But okay, so for now I'm going to lower the volume on this. All right, let's talk about that. Now, even though I thought the conference was a very solid 7 or 7.5 out of 10, at the same time, I only have three games that I wrote down which really enticed me, gave me an erection, got me hard, excited, stimulated. So, yeah, it's For Honor, which comes out on Valentine's Day, funnily enough. For Honor looked insane. That game is barbaric as fuck. And to be real, I think I kind of like it. So, I'm excited for that. I'm excited for Watch Dogs 2 and for Steep. Yeah, I'm curious about Steep because I've never really seen a game play like that before. So, first time thing for me. I can't wait to see more of that shit. But rather, I can't wait till I'm able to, like, try it out, like, demo it somewhere. Because it just looks so, like, deep. Like holy shit. And the whole snowboard. Oh, man. And wait, let's see.
We're going to be streaming live from the E3 booth at the LA Convention Center. So we'll show you a booth tour. We'll go behind the scenes. You'll see the demos, all the stage shows. Basically, you'll be able to see everything that is going on in the booth. After that, we're going to go to the Ubisoft Lounge, where we're going to do deep dives on all of the games and a special ops. Oh, you're back?
Yeah, I'm back.
I missed you.
Yeah, I miss you.
It's just not the same without Leon.
No. Trust me. We didn't miss him.
Classes tomorrow.
We didn't miss him at all.
For that. We have some really cool content for you guys, something you haven't seen before. You can interact, you can ask your questions, and we'll try to do our best to answer them.
Speaking about asking questions in teams and all that, that's kind of an awkward transition. But anyway, I just want to say hi to all the Ubisoft teams out there around the world who've been watching, helping get these things ready, get these games together. We know an amazing amount of work goes into it, and we wish you could be here. We wish you could be here with us.
We love you guys. Thank you. Thank you so much.
We are Ubisoft. And we hope you love what you saw here because I know. What was your favorite? Let's do that. Favorite moment. Leon.
Favorite moment of the show. I think it was the confetti. I love confetti.
No, okay.
You could choose between For Honor and the Division.
I choose confetti all day, every day. Confetti.
This dude.
We're tossing. Okay, that's it. We had so much stuff to say, but what I guess that's
Nintendo
it.
Store?
That is for real this time. That is it for me and Leon.
Justin, Leon,
Justin, official post show with Aisha Tyler. Let's kick it.
All right. Hey, everybody. Welcome to the UBE3.
All right, I know we don't want to watch this, so we're going to close this out for now. We're done with Ubisoft. Oh, God, we're still not done with Ubisoft. Now we're done with Ubisoft, so what's up next on the itinerary, guys? Clearly, Nintendo is doing something today. They announced it on their own Twitter. It was around 2 p.m. Nintendo. Let's see what's going on, man. Nintendo started? So, Nintendo will be on YouTube Live on E3 to talk about stuff. So, let's see. Did they start? I don't see anything from Nintendo. Live right now? I'm not seeing anything, so Nintendo did not start yet. For everybody who's telling me to do this, so I don't see them. They'll be live at 2:40 p.m. Pacific time. Right now it is 6 p.m. Eastern time, which means it's... Oh, okay, never mind. Okay, so 2:40 Pacific time. Wait a minute. Oh, it should have started already. It didn't start yet. I'm not sure what the hell the deal is, man, but we're going to have to see what's going on. It's over because they had zero views. But yeah, they did not start anything yet. So if they are going to do something, I don't know. IGN at E3. Wednesday. We also have Nintendo Treehouse Live on Tuesday. Ubisoft press conference. Sony PlayStation press conference. So, with that in mind, I'm not really seeing anything Nintendo that they're doing today. Yeah, no Nintendo stuff today, guys. I don't know what... Or, they're doing something. We'll be on YouTube Live at 2:40 p.m. Maybe we missed it. But okay, guys, for now... Let's talk about the fucking Ubisoft conference, man. Let's talk about that shit. Dudes, okay. So overall now, I know we, I'm going to stay here, I suppose, just to make sure that I don't miss out on anything that Nintendo says. Ubisoft delayed them. Still waiting out Ubisoft, I think. Okay, so we still have some time. Let's talk about the Nintendo Let's talk about the Ubisoft one, guys. Aside from me getting extremely fucking tipsy, I'm not like drunk, but I'm tipsy, admittedly. What are your overall scores of it? I mean, I gave it a 7.5 on my end. What do you guys have to say about Ubisoft's performance on your end, though? Very curious. But yeah, we still have some time to the Nintendo one, so I'm going to end this one soon. Then we're going to start up another stream. It'll be in your sub feed. You can go to that one. That's the way I have to do it, because I have multiple fucking streams of multiple reactions. A 5, 7. South Park was actually hyped, too, so I'm gonna write that down. South Park. Fractured. But whole. Six. All right, people are saying a 6. You know what? The only reason why I'm probably giving the conference from Ubisoft a 7.5 is because Watch Dogs blew that up from a 6.5 in my book. If they didn't have Watch Dogs, though, they probably would have been even lower than that. But For Honor and Watch Dogs hit me hard, dog. I'm telling you guys, man, those are going to be some massive titles. For Honor, I cannot wait to get my hands on that game. And the multiplayer aspect of Watch Dogs being able to, like, fuck with other hackers who are playing the game too. And it's going to be on PC. PC release day one. Hey, some people are saying it's too fucking long. And we see some of the custom Xbox controllers here too that we saw mentioned earlier in the Microsoft conference. So, okay, I'm seeing your scores now. Some people are saying a 6, a 2 out of 10, 4 out of 10. Okay, okay. So 6, 6, 6. All right. So it's all good. I see what the overall scores are, 5 to 6. So you guys, I guess, weren't too enthralled by it. But all right. Now, okay. Now, here's another thing. Microsoft, Ubisoft. Which one was better? Which one did you enjoy more? Microsoft or Ubisoft? Which one? Which soft did you prefer? Micro or Ubi? Just type out which company you thought one over the other one in the chat. I want to see. Is it all going to be Microsoft? Is it all going to be Ubisoft? I think it's all going to be Microsoft. It's all going to be Microsoft, I think. Or maybe I'll be surprised. Who knows? Microsoft? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Here we go. Everyone's telling me Microsoft. Damn, niggas. Damn, niggas ain't even joking out here. They're like, yeah, Microsoft all day, bro. Oh shit, niggas ain't even joking around, bruh. Alright, you know what I'm gonna do? Let's make this even more official. Who did E3 better? Microsoft. Ubisoft. Let's actually see what some data and hard numbers actually say. No duplication checking. Let's create that poll. Alright. Let me know by typing your response in the straw poll. Or choosing your response in the straw poll. I'm curious, man. Let's see how this goes. Because, you know, the people type in the chat and all that. But, I mean, there's people that are watching me right now. And, you know, I'm talking about you. You're watching me right now. And you haven't said a single thing in the chat. Usually the chat comprises like maybe a couple hundred people, but there's thousands of niggas in here. So I want you, the person who has not said a single word in that chat box since the stream started, to give me a genuine response in the stuff that I spammed in the chat. Which one do you think is the overtaker of E3 currently, Microsoft or Ubisoft? I want to see. I'm going to choose, you know, Microsoft overall. You know, Microsoft overall. I gave, oh God. Oh, this is a fucking massacre. Oh God, damn, don't do it to him. Don't do it to him. He wasn't ready. They weren't ready. Oh, no. Oh, no. Never mind. There was no competition here. Microsoft won so far. They have E3. But, guys, I'm being real with you. The company that I was looking forward to the most with E3, even though Sony did not, even though Sony already said that they were not going to be showcasing anything about their new PlayStation, I was still looking forward to them the most, since Nintendo said they would only do one thing. And the reason is because there's a lot of games on Sony's end with Square Enix that I'm excited for. I want Final Fantasy. I want Kingdom Hearts 3. I want 7 Remake. I want, what other game was coming out on the Sony side of things? I wrote it down. I have a list of stuff that I'm really hype about. This is usually when I stream. It's hard for me to keep all those things in mind. So, oh, The Last Guardian. The Last Guardian, dog. And Sony VR as well. Yo. These are going to be the things that make... These are some of my favorite things right here. And I cannot wait until Sony goes in. Now, for some reason, their broadcast is at 9 p.m., which is in roughly 2 hours and 50 minutes. 3 hours, I guess. So, we have some time to kill, man. But Nintendo's apparently doing this conference on their own. I love how Nintendo's like, oh, actually, you know, don't worry. We're doing something too, guys, okay? We're not going to be lifting the dust now. Yeah, we're doing something. Trust me on that, guys. So, okay, Nintendo, if you really want to bring out some guns on E3, then why not? They have some indie titles that are going to be shown to us. And indie is indie, you know? Sometimes you lose your mind over it. A lot of times you don't really care. But let's see what's going on, dude. There's been a couple of Nintendo indie titles that have blown my socks off. I'm just curious as to where in the fuck the actual stream is. We know the Treehouse is tomorrow, but that's not what this thing is. They're showing us indie games. So, lead us the way, man. Let's see what's going on. I don't see shit. But alright, guys, for now, the Ubisoft conference is done. So, I will be seeing you guys in a little bit. We're going to be starting a new stream. So, look in your sub feed. It should be right at the top. And we're going to be watching or waiting for whatever the hell this Nintendo thing is. So I'll see you guys then. Peace!